You remember the woman named Amanda Collins, a rape survivor in Colorado, who testified that she wanted the right to have a firearm on campus. She is a CCW permit holder, but because it is illegal to have a firearm on campus, she did not have one. She was raped at gunpoint in a University of Nevada, Reno parking garage in October of 07. Was raped 50 feet away, by the way, from campus police. Her attacker was a serial rapist who had raped two other women and murdered another one and attacked her in what I call a kill-free zone. Others call it a gun-free zone. At the time of the attack, as I mentioned, she had a CCW permit, but because of university policies against carrying a concealed weapon, she didn't have it. So she testified, and she said, "How does rendering me defenseless protect you against a violent crime?"
"Soon, what I described to you earlier will fade into your memory, and you probably won't think about it again, but I can't pray it away. I live every day with the implications being a survivor of rape and what they have on my life, which I cannot go into because..."
So she went into what happened to her. And then there's a Colorado state senator named Evie Hudak, H-U-D-A-K. Now, we're talking about allowing women to have positions of combat. And we were just talking about Christopher Dorner and my assertion that Christopher Dorner had no business being on the force. And one of the reasons he might have been on the force in the first place was because he was black. And I say that because the LAPD has a mission, and the mission is to have a police department that is reflective of the racial diversity of the city. And so when the city, quote, needs, close quote, more of a certain ethnicity or a certain gender, they will lower standards in order to do so. That may very well be the case regarding Christopher Dorner. At one time, one of the activists out here in L.A. wanted almost 50% of the police force to be female. One big problem, you don't have a large number of women applying to be members of the force. And so we've got about 15% or so of the force female. And listen to what this Colorado state senator said to this rape survivor about what would have happened to her had she had a firearm. Now think about this as we're talking about female cops and we're talking about females in combat.
"Thank you for sharing your story, very unsettling story. I just want to say that actually statistics are not on your side, even if you had had a gun.
Wow.
You said that you were a martial arts student and yet, person experienced in taekwondo, and yet because this individual was so large, was able to overcome you, even with your skills. And chances are that if you had had a gun, then he would have been able to get that from you and possibly use it against you. I mean, the Colorado Coalition Against Gun Violence says that for every one woman who used a handgun to kill someone in self-defense, 83 were murdered by them."
I have no idea where she got that number, but here again, you have a Democratic politician lecturing an American on what is the appropriate way for you to defend yourself. Blows the mind. And she said the statistics are not on your side. Really? In the 80s, there was a series of rapes in Orlando, Florida. Over a nine-month period of time, 33 women had been raped. Over 1 9-month period of time. Orlando Sun Sentinel got together with the police to offer a firearm safety course, very well publicized. Everybody knew, according to an article I'm reading from WorldNet Daily, everybody knew that there were 6,000 women who had handguns and who knew how to use them. Result, in the following 9-month period, I mentioned before, that first 9-month period, 33 women had been raped. The following 9-month period in Orlando, 3 rapes. In addition, crime in general declined. Orlando, Florida was the only U.S. city with a population of over 100,000 in that particular year that saw a reduction in crime. Quote, after the 1987 Florida right to carry legislation, homicide, firearm homicide, handgun homicide rates all declined. 8 of Florida's largest 10 cities experienced drastic decreases in homicide rates from 87 to 1995, Jacksonville down 46%, Miami down 13%, Tampa Bay down 24%, Orlando down 41%, and so forth. Miami Beach was down an incredible 93%. This is after Florida passed the right to carry legislation. In fact, one crime that saw an increase were people being carjacked leaving the Miami airport because they knew when you come off a plane you didn't have a firearm, so the bad guys targeted people who were easier targets. And this woman told her that the stats aren't on her side. Unbelievable.
Thank you for sharing your story. Very unsettling story. I just want to say that, actually, statistics are not on your side, even if you had had a gun. You said that you were a martial arts student and...
Okay, then why are we allowing women to be in combat? They obviously can't handle firearms. And what are we doing talking about female police officers? Obviously, if you have training in martial arts, you're going to be overpowered, says this state... Senator from Colorado. So why are we even having this discussion about having females and in combat and females on the police department? I'm just asking.